Praise the Lord, hallelujah. Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, we are in the second day of the Marian devotion. Now, at this moment, we are in the presence of God. We are with the Father, we are with the Son, we are with the Holy Spirit. We are not alone, because Jesus Himself said, "Wherever two or three are gathered in my name, there am I." We believe that Jesus is with us. Let us ask the Spirit of the Lord to come to us, to dwell in us, to listen to the Word of God, to learn from Mary for our lives. Let us close our eyes for the moment and pray for the grace. Gracious Heavenly Father, we come before you this morning with a thankful heart. Lord, continue to sustain us and give us the strength to walk through the path that seems harder for us. Increase our faith and hope in you, and hold our hand and help us to stand fast during the most trying times. Lord, we firmly believe that even in the most difficult of situations, you are with us and that your grace is sufficient. No matter what pressures we may have to face, thank you for equipping us with the whole armor of God. Lord, we firmly believe that everything happened has its right purpose and will finally reveal your glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Today, we are going to reflect on the three crucial scriptures related to Mary. Each one is well known to us because time and again we reflect on that passage. Now, reflecting on this passage, our goal is to let Mary's song and Mary's spirituality becomes our own song and our own spirituality. So let us listen carefully and reflect on these scripture readings. The first one is the Annunciation. St. Luke chapter 1 verse 38. Those who have Bible with you, please take up. Luke 1:38. Mary responds to the angel of God, "Be it done to me according to your will." That is, let God's will be done. That is the first passage. The second scripture we see, St. Luke chapter 2 verse 48. St. Luke chapter 2 verse 48. It is a scene called Finding of the Jesus in the Temple. Joseph and Mary were very upset when they found that Jesus was missing. And when they found him after 3 days, they say, "Son, why have you done this to us? Your father and I have been searching for you in sorrow." The third instance is taken from Holy Gospel according to St. John chapter 2 verse 5. It is a very familiar passage to us, that is wedding at Cana. There Mary says, "Do whatever Jesus tells you. Do whatever Jesus tells you." So based on these three scripture reading, we are going to reflect today on Mary. First one is God's will. When Mary said, "I am the servant of the Lord," that we have seen in St. Luke chapter 1 verse 38. "I am the servant of the Lord, let His will be done in me." She made a lifelong, permanent promise of fidelity to God. It was not for the time being, it was not for 1 or 2 days, but from her saying yes to the Lord till the end of her life. Thereafter, her life and doing were totally obedience to God's will. She evangelized with Jesus in Galilee. She witnessed the passion and death of her son. She stood at the foot of the cross and accepted her role as the mother of all Christians and all people all over the world. There we see that Jesus is entrusting Mary to Saint John, saying that, John, here is your mother, that we see in Saint John chapter 19 verse 26. So by entrusting Mary to John, Mary becomes the mother of all human race. That is the result of doing God's will in the life of Mary. And her super virtue from this passage is her total obedience to God's will. Next one, the passage which we saw, the Mary and Joseph in the temple, Mary as parent. Parents can easily identify with Joseph and Mary the day they lost their son Jesus. Parents know the agony of searching for a child who has gone astray. In today's world, we see the youth, they go on their own way. They don't understand the pinch of the pain of their parents. They go as they like. They say it is the fashion and they go. They do not listen to the parents at all. So the mother knows that agony when son is not listening to her. The same feelings they underwent. Though Jesus was very obedient to their parent, when they did not find Jesus with them, they undergo the agony. When they found Jesus, Mary corrected him. They gave Jesus his due freedom. She replied the scripture of her time to fulfill her maternal vocation, as in Proverbs 22:6, which says, train a boy the way he should go. Therefore, this is the lesson for every parent. They should be training their son according to the way they should go. Next one is the passage from Wedding at Cana, is leading others to Jesus. We all know the story from the second chapter of St. John, the wedding at Cana. She says, do whatever he tells you. In those simple words, Mary verified her role as the one who leads others to Jesus. She says, obey my son. He is the divine son of God, our savior. She said, he is the one and only intercessor between God and man. He is my savior and your savior. So only he can do the impossible things. Mary's great legacy lies in calling the world to faith in Jesus. From generation to generation, she evangelizes saying, do whatever Jesus tells you. Mary's evangelizing mission is leading the people to Jesus. That is why Pope Paul VI called Mary the star of evangelization. Therefore, by reflecting on these three passages, we see that Mary doing God's will in her life. When Mary went to visit her cousin Elizabeth, she was greeted in this way. How honored am I that you, Mary, the mother of God, come to visit me. This was the statement made by the Elizabeth. Yes, Mary's presence is transforming presence. When we take Mary along with us, our lives will be completely transformed. As she says, she will lead us to Jesus Christ. And how honored we are to be the church today, to have Mary with us, to know Mary and pray with Mary. May we imitate her virtues of obedience to God's calling, union with others in the body of the church, and be an active witness for Jesus wherever we go. Today, let us ask for this grace through the intercession of Mary, our mother, that we may do God's will in our lives we may lead others to God always. Let us pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.